Part of the reason for China's trade advantage is their communist system. Chinese companies have easy access to affordable credit provided by their own government.
Most importantly, the link between financing by the Chinese government and the Chinese companies, both state-owned and private Chinese companies, is so close, and there is so much more money available, that they have an enormous advantage when it comes to investing in Africa.
It's easier when you go in, you need a certain raw material, you negotiate the deal, as China would do, you set the state-owned enterprises loose in getting it done, you build some roads, you might build a port, and you're able to make the cash register ring immediately.
The problem is China's situation is so government directed and the U.S. Program is so privately directed that if you cannot encourage American private companies to engage, there isn't going to be engagement.
But the U.S. has far from given up on its longtime trading partner. The African Growth and Opportunity Act has opened new U.S. markets to African goods, and trade is up 22% over the past year.
There's no inherent reason why Chinese companies or China should be seen as being invincible in Africa.
They've made tremendous strides, no question about it. They are a great power today. They're going to continue to be a great power, and that's okay. But we shouldn't cower in the wake of that, or we shouldn't be concerned that somehow they're going to overtake the world.
I think we've done well with the African Growth and Opportunity Act, which has resulted in a significant increase in African exports to the United States. That was a good policy initiative. Since that act, I think we've done, quite frankly, very little.
The big difference between American foreign policy and Chinese foreign policy, and I've studied both for several decades now, is that the Chinese always have a kind of a long-term strategy. So it's important, I think, for United States in dealing with the rest of the world now to try to match the Chinese in developing a kind of long-term strategy. Say, where does United States want to be in Africa, especially sub-Saharan Africa, 10, 20, 30 years down the road?